Almost 14 billion years ago, an event occurred that changed our world forever. Technically, it created it. I'm talking about the Big Bang. But what if it happens again? Will we get another universe? An infinite number of universes? A parallel reality? Will time restart? Or will the new Big Bang be the end of the world? Today, I'm going to tell you about one of the most mysterious theories in cosmology. I'll start with the main thing. Our planet is doomed. In about 7.5 billion years, the Earth will probably be thoroughly cooked when the dying sun turns into a red giant and swallows our planet. But this is just one of the planets in the solar system. Our star is one of a huge number of other stars in the universe. It's estimated that there are about 7 billion of them, that is, one with 24 zeros. And all of these stars must die one day. The universe must die. This seems logical. What has a beginning must have an end. And one of the possible scenarios for the destruction is a new Big Bang, or something very similar to it. You probably know that the universe is constantly expanding and accelerating. At least, that's what scientists think. It's now expanding at a rate of 75 kilometers per second, or 46 miles per second, over 3 million light years. The universe has been expanding ever since the Big Bang, because it was really powerful. The energy produced by this event was equal to the explosion of 950 sexdecillion megatons in TNT equivalent. That's like 16 sexdecillion Tsar Bombas. Since then, the galaxies have been constantly moving away from each other. But one day, the expansion may stop. This is just a theory that I found in open sources, but many scientists are taking it seriously. First, the rate of expansion will slow down due to the gravitational pull of all matter, reach zero, and then everything will go in the opposite direction. But this doesn't mean that time will necessarily flow in the opposite direction, although it's possible, nor that you will personally move in a different way. A shrinking universe, in general, will be very different from a simple expanding one that is rewound. While the early universe was very uniform, the shrinking universe will break up into separate, isolated groups. Huge clusters of galaxies will converge. Then entire galaxies will begin to merge. At some point, the stars will be so close to each other that they'll have to collide, and such collisions will be frequent. As a result, the stars simply will not be able to dissipate the heat generated and will start to explode, leaving a hot, inhomogeneous gas. Because of the rising temperature, the atoms of this gas will break down into elementary particles, which will be absorbed by black holes. Then the black holes will merge into larger ones. Many of them will merge into a single black hole, a singularity. Astronomer Yvette Sendes calls it the dark reflection of the Big Bang. The closer it gets to the conditional center, the faster the process will unfold. Scientists call it the Big Crunch. For a large compression to occur, certain conditions must be met. According to Hubble's law, the expansion state of the universe is determined by its density. There's a critical value of 5.5 hydrogen atoms per cubic meter. That's 1/16 of a hydrogen atom per cubic foot. As long as the density remains lower than this, the universe will continue to grow in size and remain cooling. If the density of the universe becomes greater than this value, then gravity will gradually stop the expansion of the universe and reverse it, and it will end up returning to the original state of the Big Bang, which will surely destroy everything, both alive and inanimate. This theory has its weak points. The astronomer Yvette Sendes, whom I've already mentioned, believes that the discovery of dark energy has greatly undermined the theory of the Big Crunch. We can assume that because of this substance, the universe will continue expanding forever. However, dark energy remains poorly understood, which means that its properties may be quite different. But what if the big crunch isn't the end? There actually exists a cosmic sequel called the Big Bounce. Physicists Neil Turok and Stefan Gehlen have spoken most fully about it in the journal Physical Review Letters, though the idea isn't new. The universe is constantly going through a cycle of infinite expansion and contraction. Perhaps our universe was created as a result of the collapse of a previous one. It's impossible to determine what kind of rebirth it is, because every time the universe passes the singularity point, it's reset to zero. In other words, after a big crunch, there's another big bang which creates a new universe. It expands and cools until it also reaches its limit, then begins to contract, and it all happens again. So the universe will exist forever. The big crunch is not the only kind of big bang that can be expected in the future. In the year 2018, Harvard physicists Anders Andreessen, William Frost, and Matthew D. Schwartz came to some sensational conclusions. They said that the universe could collapse because of the Higgs boson, the very particle that was so feared when launching the Large Hadron Collider. And you know, it seems that their fears were partially justified. The Higgs boson is the smallest elementary particle that gives mass to other particles. If it somehow becomes destabilized, the entire universe will burst into a powerful explosion, burning everything from one end of space to the other. Not exactly what you'd expect from a classic Big Bang, but its scale is on par. But you can't just take the Higgs boson and shake it to trigger the end of the world. The researchers from Harvard believe that only the curvature of space-time around a black hole can deprive the Higgs boson of stability. Since these regions don't act in accordance with the laws of standard physics, a black hole could theoretically change the mass of the Higgs boson and destabilize it. This would be the end of the world, according to Stephen Hawking. But nothing like this is going to happen for another 10 million trillion 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 years. 10 and 139 zeros is the time between now and the next Big Bang. And even when it happens, it's unlikely we'll have enough time to understand what's happening or be afraid. Since the Higgs field, which is formed by the bosons of the same name, is evenly distributed throughout the universe, everything that exists within it will instantly evaporate. You can't know for sure what the end of this world will be, but the Harvard scientists are 95% sure that it will happen exactly in this way. By the way, the Big Bang could be happening right now, this very second, while you're watching this video. Do you feel any changes? The point is that it can happen outside of our own universe. There's a multiverse theory that makes every fantasy story we've heard about parallel worlds into a reality. According to it, the multiverse is like a big boiling pot or a lot of soap bubbles. They move independently of one another. Some can be very similar, some have different sizes, and periodically collide. Such a collision could have triggered the Big Bang that created our universe. It's not known how many universes a multiverse can contain, presumably an infinite amount. So right now, two of them may be creating something new. Everything I've told you today is theory, even for the most famous researchers. Most likely, over time, scientists will change their point of view. For example, they will reveal all of the secrets of black holes, or they could discover an entrance to a parallel reality. But this is a completely different story, and a topic for a separate video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Click on the bell to receive timely notifications of the release of new interesting videos that are waiting for you ahead.